Hey, maniacs, macabre. I'm back again. It's the Horror Heathen for the Horror Heathen YouTube channel and the South Jersey Horror Podcast. Again, I have another special guest today, LC Holt. He starred in the movie You're Next, a movie about a home invasion. So, and I must admit, this movie is a lot better than The Strangers, in my opinion. So it's a lot more gorier, a lot more death scenes, and I specifically love this movie now. I'm going to have to download it somewhere and just watch it. So, Kevin from Home Alone has nothing on these people when it comes to home invasions. So grab your home invasion kits and let me bring in Mr. LC Holt. How are you doing, sir?
I'm doing good. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. That was a really crappy introduction. I'm so sorry. I was not prepared for this.
No, it was fine. It was fine. It was funny. It was funny that you mentioned Kevin and Home Alone, because that was definitely an influence on your next.
Was it really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, there were scenes in that movie that we said was our Home Alone scenes. I mean, Adam Wingard, the director of that movie, who I'd worked with several times before, I've known him for years before we did Your Next. Like the scene where I step on the nail, he was like, well, I came to him and yeah, I read reading the script. I was like, you know what this reminds me of? And he said, what? And he said it in such a way that, you know, he kind of knew. And I said, it's kind of like Home Alone, you know, when Daniel Stern steps on the nail and then goes backwards down the stairs. And he's like, yes, it's the Home Alone scene. And I said, okay, great. Well, I knew exactly how to play it at that point, you know, because, yeah, it's the Home Alone scene for sure. It's the stepping on the nail, except my foot goes all the way into it, whereas Daniel Stern just kind of went halfway and stopped. You do a horror movie, it's always a little bit more than what anybody else had done, you know, up until then. So my foot went down into it and I bled so profusely. I mean, my character is pouring, you know, blood out of his boot, which obviously in reality, if you step on a nail, you're not going to bleed that much, but it's a horror movie, you know, so massive amounts of blood came out of my foot in that one.
The guy said, great. Now you're going to get your DNA everywhere. And you're like, I'll just clean up later.
Yeah, I'll clean it up later. Good luck with that, you know.
I must admit, like I said, this movie is a lot better than The Strangers. The kill scenes are a lot better. They're just fantastically done. And like I said, today was the first day I watched it. I don't know why I was hesitant to watch it before. I was like, okay, it's just another typical home invasion movie, whatever. But I sat down and watched it. It's like, holy shit, this is the shit.
So, yeah, I mean, that film, it's been over 10 years since I shot that movie. It came out a couple years after we shot it for various reasons that, you know, the studio, it was bought by Lionsgate after a film festival screening. I think it was in Toronto, Canada. I think, don't quote me, but I think that's where they bought it. And it was either TIFF, which is the Toronto International Film Festival, or it was Fantastic Fest. But either way, Lionsgate purchased it. And then Lionsgate had acquired the company Summit Entertainment, which had it made all the Twilight movies. And yes. Summit had done a lot of like young oriented sort of horror or that sort of thing. And so at that point, you know, Lionsgate now had doubled the amount of movies to release on their slate. So You're Next, because they wanted to do it as a big theatrical, kind of got pushed by a couple years. So we shot it in 2011 and it came out, I believe, in 2013. Yeah. But that was why the delay. And then it came out, and I mean, in some ways, I think the delay was good because they created this marketing strategy. In some ways, I think the delay hurt the film a little bit because in the amount of time that it took between us finishing the film and it selling and it coming out, you know, another company wrote, directed, produced, and distributed a movie called The Purge. Mm-hmm. And The Purge came out a couple months before You're Next. So it's one of those things where it almost looks like we came out as influenced by The Purge, but in actual fact, like You're Next was finished long before they ever made The Purge, you know, and it just took a long time because of this merger with Summit for it to come out. So I think that hurt the movie a little bit in the box office, even though it did really well for a movie produced under $1 million. But I don't know how many movies you can release in the 2 or 3 month period that has the concept of people wearing masks trying to get into your house. You know, sometimes you oversaturate with that. It's like trying to release 2 asteroids hitting the Earth movies in the same summer, you know.
Yeah, or it's
two volcano erupting movies in the same summer. But I mentioned that because both of that those actually happened. You know, it was the year that they released 2 asteroid movies and then 2 volcano movies. So it's like whichever one comes first has a little bit of the edge over the other one. Yeah.
Okay, so after you read the script, what was your initial thoughts? Like, what am I getting myself into? Or like, were you like excited that you're doing this role?
Well, I mean, the script came to me because I'd worked with Adam Wingard, who directed that movie and has since gone on to direct movies like The Guest and Godzilla versus King Kong and Death Note and everything. I've known Adam for a long time. The very first feature-length film, which was a horror movie called Homesick, that he directed, I was a co-star in that. And that's where I met him. I auditioned for him as an actor. And he cast me in that movie. And then after that, I remember there was a certain scene on that movie we did it. And then him and E.L. Katz, who wrote and produced Homesick, and Adam directed it. And E.L. has gone on to become a director in his own right, making movies like Cheap Thrills and with Pat Healy. And but at that time, they were both right out of film school. And there was a certain scene in Homesick, and he was like, our next movie you're going to be in. And I was like, okay, whatever. and then we did some short films, and sure enough, every time Adam would do a short film, he would call me. And then we did this movie, Pop Skull. He called me up to do that. And then I did another movie, which I won't talk about too much. It was a really bad movie and a really horrible experience and making it. And so for about 3 or 4 years at that point, it was the kind of experience in filmmaking, which sometimes actors or producers run across, where it's like, you go, if this is what it's going to be, I'd rather do anything but this, you know? And so I kind of said, I'm not doing any more films. And so for about 3 or 4 years, I didn't. And Adam called me up out of the blue and said, I got another movie going, and there's a part and you're going to play it. And I said, I am. And he said, yeah, I'm going to send you the script and you're playing this part. I know you say that you're not going to act anymore. You're going to play it. And I said, okay, well, he sent me the script and it was You're Next. And I read the script and I was like, man, this is a really fun script. Like, it's exciting. It's got action in it. You know who the people are. Like, there's character development. Like, you get to know the people before it happens to them, before the shit hits the fan. And then when it does hit the fan, it's like an action kind of horror movie, you know? And I was like, wow, that's a really great script. And so I called up Adam and I told him, well, you know, man, I've known you for a long time and I think you're the most talented dude that I've ever worked with. So anything you want to do, if you want me to be in this, I'll do it. And so that's how Your Next happened. And it completely changed my life and my career. Like, you can very much divide my career into the 10 years before Your Next and then the 10 years after. Which now, you know, everybody knows me for Your Next. They know me for the film I did right after that called VHS 2, which the VHS series is very, very popular. And then all of a sudden, you know, it was like my career took off. And like, I've done 8 films in the last year and a half, you know. So it was, and you know, when I was doing Your Next, there were people coming up to me on the set and they were saying stuff like, you know, after this movie comes out, you're going to be doing conventions. You better get used to signing things. People are going to be offering you parts. And, you know, after about 10 years of working, you know, with a little break in there, I had heard that so many times, because every movie that you do, the people always tell you, this is the one, this was going to hit. And you, at a certain point after, like I say, about a decade, you go, yeah, right. Okay. I'll take it, but yeah, okay, whatever. But sure enough, like, you know, week after the movie, I get a convention manager. I didn't even know what a horror convention was. I mean, I'd heard of them. And then next thing I know, I'm doing horror conventions and people are offering me roles in movies, their films. And I did VHS 2, like I said, and just a number of other films since then. And it's really been a great thing in my career and in my life. So I look back on Your Next very, very fondly with great admiration, because it really was a turning point in my career, you know, big turning point.
That's good. That's outstanding. And it's amazing how actors are picked up for these roles and then their career just progresses. Mm-hmm. And it's cool to watch. And people that are winning awards, and I'm happy for everybody who this happens to. I mean, mm-hmm. and you mentioned you were in VHS 2. I'm trying to place your character because I've seen the movie about 6 times. So.
Yeah, VHS 2, I was the guy that blew my face off.
And the hanging jaw and everything?
Yeah, the jaw and the tongue hanging out.
Okay.
Yeah. I was in the wraparound section of that movie, which was written and directed by Simon Barrett, who wrote and produced Your Next. So right after it wasn't long, maybe a couple months after we finished shooting Your Next, long before it ever came out, Simon called me and said, I'm going to do, don't tell anybody, but you know that movie that just came out that everybody liked, VHS? And I said, yeah, because I'd seen it at that point, because Adam had directed a segment in it. And actually, when we were shooting Your Next, Adam showed me his segment. But it didn't really click with me, like, what the movie was, like, oh, it's going to be different. It's an anthology with different little stories. Like, I didn't quite understand it until I saw the final version of VHS. And then I was like, oh, okay, cool. Yeah, I get it. And then Simon called me up and was like, well, we're going to do, secretly, we're doing VHS part 2. But you can't tell anybody, but you're going to play this role in it. That's the way I always is with those two guys. It's like, you're going to do this. And I'm like, okay.
Yes, sir.
Sure. And so... So he sent me the script for that, and I had already seen the full completed VHS at that point, and the first one, and I understood the concept at that point. And so I went and we did VHS 2, and had to keep it secret for a long time until they officially announced it. I mean, even though we had to keep a lot of secrets on Your Next, I could tell people what I was doing, basically. I just couldn't talk about the story. VHS 2, I couldn't even talk about that I was in, that the movie existed, you know, for a long time until they officially announced it. But that's how it is now with movies. I mean, that's an extreme version, but with the internet and stuff like that, it's, you know, people are so afraid of things getting out because it's so easy to leak stuff.
Yeah.
Spoil it. So
yeah, that's,
I mean, nowadays you can't, they don't let you talk about anything nowadays. And I totally get it. Like, having directed films and produced films myself, I get it. Like, you don't want to spoil the movie before a year before someone sees it.
So while you were filming Your Next, everything was shot in the dark. Was it difficult to see anything while you're trying to film that movie, or was it, you had like night vision goggles or anything special to work around?
Oh, I couldn't see out of that mask at all, hardly. Yeah, the mask had, if you watch the movie again, you'll see the mask has two little slits
there. Yeah,
that are straight up and down. And I don't know who put the slits in there, but they're two very close together, much closer together than human eyes. And so I was blind out of one eye. I couldn't see anything. And then I could see through the other eye. So negotiating stares and stuff while still looking badass was a little difficult. you know, I learned how to act partially blind in Your Next.
You can't see me, but I'm cross-eyed right now.
Yeah. So if that was a real story and my character actually had to do the things that he did in the movie, he would have to have some sort of psychic ability to be able to shoot people with crossbows and stuff. But it looks good. It looks cool.
It does. I mean, I'm like, I'm going to lock my doors. Yeah. Board up my windows now.
Yeah. It's a really funny movie, too. It's got a lot of humor in it, which... Sometimes I don't think people read it, you know, but there were times on the set when we were laughing, like, you know, that it was really funny to us, you know, and even watching the movie, there are parts that make me laugh. And I don't know if it's because, you know, I think about the experience and I know what we laughed at when we were making it, But I mean, like when Amy Simons, for instance, is running toward the front door in slow motion, and then she suddenly hits that piano wire. It's to me, that's just hilarious. You know, it's really funny.
Yeah,
in a dark and a morbid way, of course. Yeah.
Well, you got to find the humor in that in order to get past all the other stuff. So,
yeah,
it's just, I can't believe that. What baffles me is like some of these stories are based on true stories, these movies, and I don't think Your Next is based on a true story or inspired by true events, because no. I know The Strangers is, that's based on true events, but it just scares me how this can happen to anybody at any time. And I was sitting there watching the movie, trying to figure out what's the motivation behind this? Why are they inviting the house? And then later on in the movie, it's revealed that the guy is trying to inherit his dad's money in his estate. So, and he's going to pay you guys. Like, okay. So,
yeah. A lot of really good actors in that movie. AJ Bowen was the, first and foremost is Sharni Vincent, who played Aaron, the star of the movie. Really great Australian actress. And she's just as much a badass as she comes off in the movie, but just a real sweet person. And AJ Bowen, who played her boyfriend, who has the big monologue at the end, and she stabs him in the throat. And Nick Tucci, who was the other brother who was in on it, who unfortunately we lost him way too early. He has since passed away. But and Amy Simons. Myself, Lane Hughes, Barbara Crampton, of course, just as beautiful as she was back in the films she did in the 80s, and even 10 times more talented, just a really great talent. And so, yeah, it was a fantastic cast, fantastic crew, great location, that house, and we just got to destroy it.
I know, right? But that was fun, though, destroying it.
Oh, it's great. I mean, it was a multi-million dollar mansion, and they were renovating it at the time. And there were certain things we couldn't do. Like, we couldn't really break the windows and stuff. Like, that, the way you see of the bolts shooting in through the window and the scene where Sharni's character jumps out the second story window, they took out the antique windows and they reconstructed a fake window, put it in. They weren't going to let us actually destroy the antique windows and stuff like that, But it was a great location. Yeah, I love that house. And all the stuff I shot and most of the movie takes place in that one location. So we were pretty much, it was kind of like home, That's where we worked night after the long night.
Well, it is a great movie, and I'm glad I watched it. So,
yeah, I
think your character had the best weapon.
Yeah, and I got to do a little bit of both, because I had the crossbow and then I pick up the axe at one point, so I got the best of both worlds. I had to got to do some crossbow action and got to do some axe stuff. Of course, they wouldn't let me shoot the crossbow because they're, for insurance reasons, they're not going to let an actor shoot on a set.
Well, that sucks.
Yeah. But so the actual crossbow being shot was done by a stunt coordinator. But the one I hold in the movie was a safety crossbow, because they don't want me accidentally shooting someone for obvious reasons. But the axe, like, I got to chop through that door, door made of balsam wood. Fake door, not the antique door. They took that one off and put in the movie door. I mean, that was one of the things when I was axing through that door. Another one of those times on a movie set where you go, this is so hilarious because the door won't be, you can't cut through it. We spent the production spent so much time shooting that me axing through that door. You would be shocked how long it took. Because every time I'd hit the thing, the whole fake little panel would pop out. Like, for some reason, this real axe would not go through that balsam wood. And it's always the simplest stuff on these movies. Like, the simplest stunt, the simplest effect that takes you hours and hours and hours to get. And then the big stuff, like the building exploding or the car flipping over, you get that in one take. No problem, But when you're trying to use a real axe through fake wood, you're going to be there for like 3 hours trying to get the damn thing to work right. Yeah, that's
was that
always
the hardest scene? Was that the hardest scene you had to do? Was the axe in the wood?
Yeah, that was probably the most frustrating because it should have been so simple, but like I say, the simplest thing is always ends up being the hardest, you know. I can't really remember a scene in that movie that was really difficult for me. Most of them went pretty well, pretty quickly, and you know, we got everything we needed in a reasonable amount of time. But the door did take a long time to chop through that door. And what you see in the movie is really, it's just edited, because the door never really worked right. Like, we never really got a good chop. So if you, they just kind of cut it where it looks like I'm chopping the door more than I actually was. Because that damn door never really worked, you know, but it worked enough.
And I think your death was one of the most gruesome deaths in that movie. You get the screwdriver in the head. And yeah, I was like, oh man, that sucks.
Well, you know, originally it was a different death in that movie for myself and for Sharni's character at the end. In the original script, I get into the room and Sharni takes a knife and stabs me through my hand, and it stabs in through my hand into my head. And I drop the axe, and she picks up the axe and swings it at my neck and chops my head off. And my head rolls off, my severed head rolls off my shoulders and ends up in my lap. And it looks like I'm holding my own head like a basketball in my lap. And that was how it was in the script. And then as we were shooting the movie, as sometimes happens, you start to hear little rumblings about sequels, especially with horror movies. And then it became, maybe we shouldn't like kill all the killers. Like, maybe we should give them lesser wounds. Like, maybe we shouldn't take his head totally off, you know? And they had come up with this whole concept of, if I just get stabbed in the head, in the next movie, I come back with brain damage, and now I can't feel pain anymore. So let's just do that. And that way it leaves him open to come back for a sequel. And the same thing with Sharni in the original script. When the cop shows up at the end, Sharni got shot in the head, took her out. She's dead. But then again, as we were going along, the producers were like, should we really kill the star? Like, what if we do a sequel? And so that's why in the final movie, she gets shot in the shoulder and survives, stuff like that. So yeah, there was a lot of setup for a sequel.
Oh man, this should be a sequel. That'd be awesome if you came back and you recruited more people to do another home invasion, like your guys' revenge crew or something. That'd be awesome.
That was the idea originally. It's been, like I said, it's been over 10 years since we shot it. I think if a sequel was going to happen, it would have happened already. I would be really interested to see what my character, the Landmass character, what he would be like 10 years later. Like, it does kind of interest me to do it now that I'm, you know, 10 years older.
Yeah.
It'd be interesting to see what the character was like after a decade. But that's all in the hands of Lionsgate and Snoot Entertainment, the production company. And I don't have any control over that, but I would love to do a sequel to Your Next. But I think as the years go on, it gets less and less likely that would happen. I think everybody has kind of moved on to other projects, and maybe that's good, because sometimes when you do a sequel there, you can wreck these things, you know, you can mess it up. It's possible.
So do you have any upcoming projects that you could like to tell the audience about that I can promote in this video?
Yeah, and in terms of it, as an actor, I have a number of movies coming out. I have a slasher movie, a real kind of 80s throwback slasher I shot in Texas a while back called Butcher's Bluff. I have a movie I shot not too long ago, another slasher called Late Checkout. There's a film called Macabre Mountain, which has Felissa Rose and Dave Sheridan in it. There's a movie called Go Away with Tom Matthews. I did with Tom Matthews and Tuesday Night and Robert Mukes. There's a movie I just shot, which is why I look this way. We're about to do some more shooting on it, called The House Among the Trees, which is a really great movie. I can't wait for people to see that. And then there is, if you want to talk about home invasion, there's a film that I wrote and directed that's in post-production right now called Watchdog. And if people liked You're Next and they know me from that home invasion genre, a Watchdog is very much in the home invasion milieu. It's very different than You're Next, but it is in that genre. And the trailer for that is out now. You can go watch the trailer for You're Next. And that starred, I wrote and directed it, and it starred Wes Robinson from Blair Witch, Chaney Morrow from Haunt, and Wrong Turn, the new Wrong Turn. Great young actress named Celeste Blandon, who I did a movie called Phantom Fun World with. Phyllisa Rose from Sleepaway Camp, Mark Patton from A Nightmare on Elm Street Part 2. So it's a great cast. Daniel John Kearney, who I've done a number of movies with, is also in that. And I should also mention Phantom Fun World is a movie. If you want to see me as another masked character, for years after You're Next, I did not do masked roles because I liked You're Next so much, and I thought doing another mask, like now I'm going to play, the Elephant Man, or now I'm going to play like the Llama Boy or something. I was just like, yeah, I'm not going to do masks for a while, if ever. Like the You're Next was my mask thing. Well, about a year ago, maybe a little less, a director, writer director named Tory Jones came to me with this script for this movie called Phantom Fun World. And it was a masked, the lead character is this masked killer called the Phantom. And I read it and I was like, it's been a decade since I've done a masked role. And I feel like if I ever were to do another one, like this is the film I would do it in. So I did this film, Phantom Fun World, which is the first time I'm playing a masked killer since You're Next. So if you want to see me as a masked killer again, check out this movie, Phantom Fun World, which should be coming out next year.
It's good you mentioned that because I just interviewed Spencer Madison from here being a
Yes.
Phantom World. Yeah, I
Yeah,
just talked to her a
Spencer.
couple of days ago, and I also spoke to Lydia Manson, who's also in Macaw Mountain with you.
Yeah.
So yeah,
Yeah, Spencer is a great actress. She I had a lot of fun menacing her in Phantom Fun World. And yeah, and Lydia is great in Macabre Mountain. Really big cast in Macabre Mountain. If I tried to name them all, I would miss people, so I don't even try. So but Dave Sheridan was in that movie, and I'm about to do another movie with Dave. From a Scary Movie fame, played Officer Doofy, and he was in Devil's Rejects. Me and him are we've done three. We're about to do our third movie together. In about a month and a half, we're going to do a movie called New Year's Eve, which is a
Okay.
New Year's Eve themed slasher movie. So that's what I'm going to be shooting next after I finish up with The House Among the Trees. So that's one to look out for in the future with myself and Dave Sheridan. Phyllisa Rose, who is one of my greatest friends, is also in that. And and everybody knows Phyllisa from Sleepaway Camp, and the many films she's done since then.
Yeah, she's on my list to interview, but I did meet her in person. She does follow me on social media. She's a really sweet girl.
One of the
Yeah,
sweetest people I've
yeah.
ever met.
And I just watched her in a movie called how was it called? Bloody Summer Camp. And I was watching her, I was like, she's a loudmouth counselor. And I'm like, that's not her in real life though. So
And D Dave is in that too. He played the sheriff guy. He was in that too. Yeah, I actually the movie I did Go Away that I mentioned before, same writer and director as Bloody Summer Camp. His next movie I've already shot.
But yeah, it's fantastic that all these old school characters are coming in on these new age characters and just doing all these movies. It's fantastic. I'm loving it because I'm a huge horror buff. So I'm
Yeah.
loving seeing everybody come together and just working together in all these future films.
Oh,
So.
it's great. I love working with the group, and a lot of the people, have over the years become really good friends of mine, either from working with them in films as an actor or from doing conventions with them where we were guests together. It really is a strangely small world, the horror genre, And I've come to be great friends with a lot of those people who have been around for a long time and people who are just now coming up.
And it's funny how you mentioned Butcher's Bluff because there's something I want to show you.
Oh, there he is. Yep.
The
Yep. Yeah, I can't wait for people to see that. Billy Instone wrote and directed that movie.
pig mask. I'm
And
actually interviewing him in a couple of weeks, so
well, great. Tell him hi. I love Billy.
absolutely. Well, thank you for your time. I really do appreciate it, and I love the, like I love the movie You're Next. It was I'm so glad that I watched it, and it's just that your character had such a shitty death. I just wish he would last at
Well, you never know.
the
You know, these horror characters, they pop up. You never know. You know, he might pop up again one day.
But I'll definitely be on the lookout for your other movies like Phantom Front World, because after interviewing Spencer Madison, I'm looking forward to seeing that. So, and yeah, it's been awesome. I really enjoyed this interview. It's been really cool. So,
No, it was fun. I appreciate it, man. I had a good time.
yeah, me too. So I wish you the best of your career, and I hope you win some awards for your directing and producing. Because if you don't, I'm gonna start emailing people left and right.
Okay. That's a plan. Yeah.
All right, so yeah, thanks for the interview. I really appreciate it, and I wish you the best of luck.
Thanks, man.
All right, take care.
You too.